with the project, and so are we.
All parents know the importance of bonding with their babies, but a growing number of Aussie mums are taking that attachment one step further.
Two-year-old Piper rules the roost. Her mum, Melissa, breastfeeds on demand, shares her bed and responds to every wish.
I just do what feels right and generally what's been done since the beginning of our species.
It's called attachment parenting and aims to create a bond by giving kids anything they want.
Exclusive breastfeeding for extended periods of time. Baby wearing, so you wear your baby on you the whole time. Co-sleeping, so you and your family all sleep in the same bed together.
I find that if you meet all of their needs early on, then they learn that people can be trusted.
But some experts are worried.
I think that it gives them the message that they are the centre of the universe, that everything and everyone should do everything that they want.
It's the extended breastfeeding that stirs up the most controversy, with the belief children should decide when to wean themselves. The federal government recommends exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months and then partial breastfeeding until 12 months. But many mums wean earlier.
You do hear of some mums who've got 4 and 5 year olds, and I think that's completely okay. If a child still wants to, and the mum's okay with it.
The general age of children stopping breastfeeding around the world is about 4.
The bonding is a big part of baby wearing because they're so close, and even if they're on your back, they're right there.
The idea has led to pramless baby wearing groups right across the country.
Having her close to me all the time was a big draw card for me to begin with.
If we were really supposed to be constantly carrying our infants, we would be like a kangaroo, we would have a pouch.
Mum Gabrielle takes the attachment one step further with homeschooling.
I want my children to see their siblings as their peers, not other children who randomly happen to be assigned to the same class as them. I believe that one teacher with 30 children who they're not related to cannot meet any individual child's needs as well as a parent.
Attachment parents say their babies grow up to be more independent adults.
By being available to them whenever they look for you in the early years, so that as they're older they don't need to fulfil that attachment in unhealthy ways but look for them in other relationships.
One of the fears that I have is that you could potentially develop an anxiety disorder. The message the child gets is, I need to stay with mum or parent because the world outside, you know, might be really scary.
They grow up trusting that their needs are going to be met, that people are kind, that people will listen to, they're worth listening to, their needs are worth being met.
That just looks like hard work.
I take my hat off to them. I just wouldn't have the patience to be able to do it, but if that's what a mum wants to do, that's what she should do.
I have a serious question. What if you've got 4 kids?
Have them all hanging off you.
You've got one hanging all around you.
Yeah, that's a big backpack. It's a beast of burden, I think.
I just don't get what we've been doing this for, what, 100,000 years? Haven't we figured it out yet? Why is there always a new theory all the time? I'm going to do what I call Romulus and Remus parenting. That's just your living with wolves in the forest if they come back. That'll work out. We'll take a break. Back in a tick. Tomorrow on the...